Saturday the 6th of June. Good morning. It is the weekend. And if you're doing this early in the morning, it's great. It's going to be a get up, do the workout, got the rest of the weekend ahead of you. If you're going to leave it for later in the day, then enjoy doing it later. So the workout today, we've got three rounds. Okay, we've got three rounds of 1 minute, 1 minute, 1 minute. That's one round. Then another three rounds, one minute, 1 minute, 1 minute. Another three rounds, 1 minute, 1 minute, 1 minute. Rest, and then we do three rounds of 35 reps, 10 reps, 8 reps. Okay, so there's a total work of 9 minutes there, with a little bit of a rest, and then we've got three rounds of all of this going here. So what we're doing, we've got one round, after one, we've got 1 minute of object lateral jumps, okay? So if you want to take a line, you can do a little line jumps. If you can use an object, we jump over an object. Okay, then we're going to do object dips. So either on a chair or a bench or a stool or something that you're going to be doing dips in. You can do 1 minute of dips, and then we do 1 minute of handstand push-ups, or we're going to do a hand release push-up. So if you're strong enough for handstand push-ups, we're going to do that. If you're not strong enough for that, we're going to do some kind of a hand release push-up, and then we're going to scale it either on the feet or on the knees. And it's going to be 1 minute of that, straight into 1 minute of that, straight into 1 minute of that. It may be that you can't do a full minute of work. It may be that you do 20 seconds and you need to rest, get your breath, or let your shoulders or your arms recover, do another 20 seconds of work, rest, and then do the last 10 seconds of rest, and then that's what we're working on, okay? So you're going to try and do as much work as you can, even if you don't work for the full minute, you're going to try and do as much work as you can for the duration of that time, go straight into the next movement, makes sense, okay? Then you're going to rest a little bit, short little rest, just enough to prepare yourself, then we're doing three rounds, same movements, but now we're working for repetitions. So instead of doing 1 minute, we're looking for 35 reps of object lateral jumps. It would probably be about half the amount of time, depending on how high the object is. You've got 10 object dips, also probably at least half the amount of time, and then your handstand push-ups. All right, we're going to try and make these options here as difficult as possible to make sure you get as much work as you can. There's only three rounds to get out of it. Okay, if you haven't done a lot of object dips or chair dips or that kind of thing before, you want to watch your triceps and make sure that you're not sore till tomorrow so that you can still feed your face because it's going to be a Sunday. Okay, so let's have a look at the movements. So first one, you can either use a pillow, you can use an object to jump over. Let's use something like a little bit lower today. You can use anything that you can jump over. So my first thing, we're going to jump over and jump. One, you can go nice and slowly. Two, three, four. If you want to use something slightly smaller, you can use a line. One, two, three, jumping over line. Or you can go slightly faster. One, two, three, four, five. Or you can jump slightly higher. One, two, three. You can hear something even higher than that, and then you're jumping over the object. If you want to even get a stool or a box, then you're going to do one big jump over, change, one big jump over, change, one big jump over. You can use that as an object or as a variation. Okay, that's going to be your object dance. Going for 1 minute, 1 minute. Then we're doing object dips. So you're going to grab a stool, you're going to grab a box, edge of a chair, and what we're looking for is get your hands on the edge of the box or the edge of the stool. I'm going to use my handles here, right? And you're sitting. What I'm looking for is that your shoulders aren't coming around. What we've got to focus on is opening up the chest and shoulders and pulling the shoulder blades together into this position. So from there, I'm going to sit forward, keep the chest up, don't let the shoulders come forward, and then I'm going to dip and press up, okay? Make sure that whatever you're dipping on doesn't go into your back. If you're going to go sideways, have a look at my shoulder blades. What I'm looking for is there, back straight, chest up, and I don't want to see this happen. Chest stays up, and then dip, pressing back up. Ideally, what you want to do is you're going to try and get those elbows to about 90 degrees to whatever you're doing. The deeper you go, the more work you're going to put into the front of the shoulders. So you have to focus on trying to keep this chest up so you don't have any anterior slanting in the shoulders and too much work through here. Okay. If the dipping is uncomfortable, you can just do a hold. You're going to push the dip, hold, and you're trying to keep your hips off the box as much as possible so the work is stabilizing through that shoulder girdle. Doing 1 minute of dips, 1 minute of a box hold or a dip hold, edge of a chair or a bench. Okay, next one, and you're going to 1 minute of handstand push-ups or hand release push-ups. So we'll go for our first option, hand release push-ups first. And the reason what we're looking for is you want to try and make these as slow as you can. So it's a slow handstand push-up, so we're looking for strict work. And what we're going to do, first one, handstand push-up, It's not a handstand push-up, hand release push-up. Come to the floor. Starting position is actually to keep the stomach tight, make sure I don't arch into the back too much. Keep my chest down, stomach tight, knees locked out. Hand release, push up onto the knees, lift the knees, and back down. Hand release, push up onto the knees, lift the knees. Notice that my body doesn't snake. It's not this. Coming off the floor, hips up. Try and keep my chest up. My chest and torso lifts at the same time, engages. Back down. If you're doing a bit more strict, hand release, strict, press, release, strict, press. What I'm not doing, it's not this, hit those down, just the shoulders. Press, hand release push-ups for 1 minute. If you can do handstand push-ups, you're gonna pop up against the wall and inverted, and you're doing head touch the floor or head touch a pillow. Slow hand release push-ups. If you want to do a pike position, feet up on the wall, and you can do a pike overhead handstand push-up, you can do it in a pike position as well. Okay, those three movements. Then we go back into your object lateral jump overs. That 1 minute of jumping is going to get your heart rate up. Straight into your object dips on the edge of a chair. Okay, your lungs are going to be going, so now you want your heart, your arms and your shoulders to do the work. Straight into your push-ups. Or your handstand push-ups, your triceps are already going to be tired from the dip work that you've done, so there's going to be extra work in the shoulders to try and get overhead. You may find that you don't get, maybe going to get two or three handstand push-ups, in which case, if you can't do any more, you're failing, you can't get up, drop to the floor, do your strict hand release push-ups on the floor, do 3 rounds in total of that, no rest in between, it's just continuous. Okay, so try and get as much work done in those 3 rounds. Then, short rest, just to get your breath, 15 seconds, 30 seconds, and then we're going into the same movements, but we're doing 35 object jumps over the object, over a line, 35. Straight into 10 object dips, okay? Try and make those options as strict as possible. On the dips, the more you take your legs out straight, the more you take your legs out straight, the harder it is. The more you bring your knees in to the sides when you're dipping, the easier it is, okay? So you can scale those things. If you want to make it even more difficult, put your foot up on a chair, both legs out in front, and you're dipping in between the two chairs or between the two benches. There's gonna be your object dips, you're doing 10 of those, then 8 slow hand release pushes. So this time there's no time, okay? So it's not a time domain. The first one you're working to 1 minute of time, doesn't matter how many reps you get in. The second 3 rounds is task-based, you have to get the work done. So it's 35 jumps, doesn't matter how long it takes you to do that. It may take you longer than a minute, okay? Then your 10 dips, again, you're trying to make it as difficult as you can, doesn't matter how long it takes you, but it should be close on failure. You're gonna find that it's gonna be quite tough. Handstand push-ups. This may be a little bit of a bottleneck for some of you. You may be gonna get 3 reps out, shake the shoulders out, another 3 reps out, shake the shoulders out, another 2 reps, that's your 8 reps for the handstand push-ups if you're doing that. If you're gonna work on a pike, work on a pike, or you're doing your hand release push-ups. That's the workout. Okay, guys, if you need a little bit more warm-up or a little bit more briefing for the warm-up, we do want to make sure you get those shoulders nice and warm, particularly for that dip work, the arms warm, as well as for that overhead work that we're doing on the handstand push-ups, okay? If your shoulders aren't warm for that, you're going to struggle. So, skip, row, run, get warm for 5 minutes. Then we do a whole body complex. And what we're doing is we're doing some alternating supine raises. We're doing some sit-up to pancake, we're doing some sit-up to straddle, and we're doing some inchworm to downward dog and cobra. So what that looks like. First one is plank raises. So we're gonna start with the legs straight out in front of you. Stomach tight. What I'm looking for is to keep this rib cage as engaged as possible. I don't want to see the back arching. Don't want you to feel the work in the low back. Stomach, this is gonna keep tight. You may feel a bit of work in the hip flexors. And you're trying to take your feet side to side as big as possible. Arms pressed out, chest up, hips, touch, touch, touch. Feet together, stomach tight, touch, touch. You've got to make sure that the work stays in the stomach, not the low back, okay? If you need to do smaller touches, side to side to protect your back, do that. If that doesn't work for you, and your back is sore when you're lifting those feet off the floor, rather lie on your back, right? And then you're doing an alternating side, 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 and your focus is to make sure that low back stays flat on the floor, and you're alternating elbows to knees, and you do 10 each side. That's gonna be your plank raises. Then sit up to pike. Heels pressed out, toes pulled back. Keep the legs nice and straight. You're going to start with the small of the lower back and the floor. Chin tucked in, up, touch, one, two. Roll back down, lower back flat on the floor. Up, touch, one, two, three. One more time, lower back flat, stomach tight, touch. One, two, three. Once you've done 10 of those, we're going to a straddle. From there, stomach tight, up, feet wide. One, two, three. You're going to feel more stretch inside the legs. Lower back, two, three, feet together, stomach tight, hop, one, two, three, 10, sit up to straddles or sit up to pancake. And then 5 inchworm to downward dog. So it's look like this. You're gonna start in a standing position and your inchworm is gonna start, chin tucked in, roll down on the spine. So there's a nice stretch in the hamstrings and the low back. You're gonna roll forward. That's your inchworm. Push up, push back, and press, roll, stand. Chin tucked in, walk forward, inchworm, press up, push back, overhead shoulder position there, and roll back up along the spine. Do 5 of those, and we're doing 2 rounds. So you go back to your first one, alternating leg raises over the side, 10 sit up to pike, straight leg, 10 sit up to straddle, wide leg, 10 or 5 inchworm with a downward dog slash push back, walk back up, get the shoulders nice and warm, 2 rounds of that. Okay, then we do a little bit more dip work and shoulder prep work. Okay, so for your shoulder prep work, you want to make sure that your shoulders are nice and warm for the work that's got coming up. We're going to start in a box dip. So we do a bit of a box dip hold, 30 seconds hold, and then 30 seconds of movement. So what we're going to do, first one, is I'm looking for, same as we briefed look earlier, is just to pull the shoulder blades back and down together, arms locked down, chest up across the front, and you're just going to bring the hips just off the end of the box and you're holding. 30 seconds. My focus here is to not allow my chest to sink between my shoulders. I've got to keep pressing down with my arms, lifting up with my chest. Lifting up, pulling the shoulders back, lifting up, pulling the shoulders back, and you're going to start to feel the work around the top and around the bottom of the shoulder blades. And that's gonna get those shoulder girdle nice and firing. Once you've done 30 seconds of that, we're doing 5 reps. 5 reps, dip, press one, dip, press two. If you need to take the legs out a little bit, you can take the legs out, it'll be more, a little bit more difficult. Dip, chest up, dip, chest up. Start with your feet closer to keep the shoulders safe. As you get warmer, you can start taking your feet out a little bit more. And then once we do, then we go to 30 seconds at the bottom of the dip. So it's 30 seconds at the top, 5 repetitions with the feet close. Then we do 30 seconds at the bottom. So back stretch, chest up, and you're gonna hold. A little bit more challenging. As you do that, don't let your body sink because you're gonna start compromising the shoulder joint here. So you wanna keep your hips up off the floor, try and keep 90 degrees in your elbow. So I'm holding. Shoulders back, chest up, holding 30 seconds. If this is too easy for you, you can take it out, but that's quite tough. So we keep the feet nice and close, okay? And then we do another 5 reps. Hold it there, keep the back nice and close to the box. So I'm not allowing the hips to come away from the box. Okay, as soon as the hip comes too far away, you can see there's that extra stretch into the shoulder. Hips close, dip, press, dip, press at the bottom. Okay, that's gonna be, we're doing 1 round of that. 30 seconds at the top, 5 repetitions. 30 seconds at the bottom, 5 repetitions. That should be enough to get the shoulders nice and warm. And then we've got a nice little series of movements to prep your shoulders a little bit more. So that last little workout prep, okay? So you're doing 1 minute in a handstand or a plank hold. So whatever progression you're gonna use here, plank position there, pike position, or handstand upside down, 1 minute there. You'll do as much work as you can in that minute. You may not be able to hold for that full minute, that's fine. Then we do 1 minute of 50 single unders, either on a skipping rope or jumping over the line, which will get you ready for jumping here. Minute 3, 4 to 5 wall climbs, which will take you through, or get up, get downs. Right, then we do minute 4, single unders or double unders or skipping or line jumps again. Minute 5 is gonna be a slow, strict handstand push-up, so the shoulders are a little bit warmer now, nice and slow. Okay, or hand release push-ups. Minute 6, double unders or single unders. Minute 7, some strict handstand push-ups again. Okay, quickly go through that. Minute 1, so we're doing either a plank position, so it's a tall plank hold. So we're gonna hold in a plank for 60 seconds,
or we're gonna hold in a pike, we're gonna push back, hold for 60 seconds, or we're gonna put your feet up on the wall, okay, and hold, hips over the top of the shoulders, 60 seconds, or you're gonna take your feet straight up the wall, pop up to the handstands, hold for as much of that 60 seconds as you can. That's minute one. Minute two, 50 single unders on a skipping rope, or jumping over the line, 50 reps, about 50 reps. Rest a little bit. Next one, wall climb. So we have been doing a few of these, so you may have seen these the last few days. Wall climb, we are going to try and get your chest to the wall, if you can. Full overhead position, stomach tight, press up. You may find that walking your feet up to there is enough. Press, walk back down, chest to floor, and you do three or four of those. If you want to do all the way up, press through, and then walk up. Lock out, head to floor or head to wall, and then walk your feet back down. Press. Yeah. If you're doing a full wall walk, do a full wall walk. If you do a push back, do a push back to a push up. You can do that. Then we're going back into single unders or double unders or line jumps, or maybe a little bit higher in your object jumps. Then we do strict handstand push-ups or hand release push-ups. So if you do handstand push-ups, your shoulders will be feeling well and warm by now. Otherwise, hand release push-ups. Press. Stomach nice and tight. Hand release push-ups, and you're doing five or six of those. Back into your line jumps, back into your double unders. And then last one, back into strict handstand push-ups. So by the time you get to the workout, you're fully warm for whatever progression of handstand push-ups, pikes, push-ups off the floor you're gonna be doing. Okay guys, that is your Saturday morning workout. So there are a lot of moving components to this workout to get you eventually to those two rounds of three rounds, okay? What I mean by the two rounds of three rounds, there's lots of work to do here. Getting mobile through the shoulders and the hips and the back. Take your time with this. Take your time with this dip and the prep work, okay? Same thing over here. Take your time through these minutes. Doesn't mean you have to smash these minutes, but there is working time to engage your shoulder girdles, get your arms locked out, build your shoulders, make sure they're getting nice and warm so that you can hit the hard work over there, okay? Give yourself one run through of whatever you're gonna do as part of your last bit of workout prep. Make sure you chose your scaling, whatever scaling is appropriate for you. And smash your Saturday workout. And then you're done. And then you can enjoy the rest of the weekend. And then it's Sunday. And then I'll see you again on Monday.